Hi, thank you for joining Pioneer. My name is Aaron Pence. I'm from the Norman Central Library. I appreciate you spending a few minutes with me today. We've got a beautiful sky full of stars. Now, let's make them twinkle. It's helpful as a programmer to know exactly what you mean. If we're going to make stars twinkle, we should be able to answer the question, what is twinkling? Well, it's when the atmosphere bends the light from a star just out of your vision, so the star appears to disappear very briefly. But we don't need to make an atmosphere with light-bending disturbances in it to get twinkling. Instead, we can just hide the stars sometimes. Nothing to it. We don't want the stars to hide all the time, and we don't want there to be too obvious a pattern to the hiding and showing. So I think we can use some weight blocks with some randomness inserted to fit the bill. Let's first build the hiding and showing so we can get the structure right. After that, we'll change the timing to make it look a little more natural. We want the stars to twinkle over and over and over again, so we'll need a forever loop. Grab one from Control and click it in under the Set Size 2 block in the When I Start as a Clone script. Inside the forever loop, we want the stars to twinkle, to show, and to hide. So go to Looks, grab a Show block, and stick it in the loop. Also, grab a Hide block and stick it in the loop. If you click the green flag now, almost all of your stars will disappear. The only one that stays is your non-clone sprite, your original star. You know what? We should probably fix that, actually. Let's hide your original star by grabbing a hide block and snapping it in under the When Green Flag Clicked button. Now your original star is just there to be cloned. Sneaky. But our other stars still disappeared. The forever loop is hiding them. They use the show block and then immediately use the hide block. The computer just interprets that as they're hidden. So you never see them. We need it to wait while they're showing to make them reappear. So go to Control and grab a Wait 1 second block. Click it in under the show block. If you click your green flag, you can see the stars sort of shimmer, right? It's cool, but it's way unnatural. It's too patterned. Let's also ask them to wait 1 second while they're hidden. Grab another Wait 1 second block and snap it in under the hide block. I think that looks neat, but it's still not what we were hoping for. It's so regular that it looks, well, it looks computerized. Things in the world are never perfect. They happen at weird times, at weird intervals, in weird ways. And you can make sense of them, but they're never right on time all the time. We need to jazz the pattern up a little to make it look more natural. Haha, random numbers to the rescue. What we're going to do is have the wait times not be a straight one. We're going to use random numbers to change the amount of time. That will disrupt the pattern so that it looks a little more natural. First, go to the green operators blocks. Now, grab two pick random 1 to 10 blocks. Snap one into the wait 1 second bubble after show, and snap the other into the wait 1 second bubble after hide. Now take a look. Well, it's a little popcorn-y, right? The problem is the wait times are too long. Let's fix them. I think a good adjustment will be to make the times longer while it's showing the stars, and shorter while it's hiding them. So, click in the one bubble of the first random in the loop, the one after show, and change the number to 3. Next, click in the 10 bubble of the first random in the loop, and change the number to 8. We also need to shorten the wait times for the hiding portion. I actually don't even want to use a number as big as 1. I need numbers that are smaller than 1, but still bigger than 0. Fortunately, there are a lot of numbers like that, the decimal numbers. Click in the 1 bubble of the last random, the one after hide, and change the number to 0.2. You type a 0, then a period, then a 2. Last, click in the 10 bubble of the last random, and change the number to 0.8. Type a 0, then a period, then an 8. And take a look. Doesn't that look cool? What a pretty sky you made. Next time, we'll send shooting stars across the night. Thanks a lot. See you soon.